So attributes of common-based, outcome-based curriculum. Actually, the outcome-based education system is the best for the autonomous institution. But we are appealing to the universities that what we need to do, we need to apply this sometime, reverse engineering process. So this is the best model for autonomous institution, academic autonomous institution. But we don't have any flexibility to train the curriculum, we are depending on the university. So when we are depending on the university, sometimes we need to apply the reverse engineering method. Otherwise, we could not be able to achieve the goal of the outcome-based education system. In this process, you see that attitudes of outcome-based curriculum. Three outcomes are based on the curriculum, such as one is the program educational outcomes. The third one is the program outcomes and program specific. You see, actually the process of the outcome-based education is it starts with the vision and mission, then departmental vision, departmental mission, then program educational objectives. So once you define the program educational objectives, program educational objectives are nothing but advertisement words only. About your program, you need to clearly specify like advertisement statement. Three statements, or two statements, or four statements, or five statements. You need to advertise your program. So for that, whatever the example is there, you can use any word, no specific word. You can design as per your benefit. But what is our aim? We need to attract many. For attracting of the people, how you can create that diversity is depending on given set of values. So program, educational objectives are nothing but advertisement statements, simply I should say. Advertisement statements. The next one is, by the help of this program education objective, then program outcomes. The program outcomes already defined by NBE, defined by NBE. So in this component, our involvement is zero. In this process, in this component, our involvement is zero. Because of already these outcomes have been defined by the NBA. And next one is the program specific outcomes. Program specific outcomes means these outcomes are relevant to the, our core area. It may be CS or it may be EC or it may be CD or it may be that. I'll share with you how to create the program specific outcomes in the end of the session. So next one, you see the part C, I'll be going to share with you assessment of the outcomes and instructional routines. So you see, course outputs and person bank using Bloom's taxonomy. You are aware of the Bloom's taxonomy. So then most of the experts might be sharing the Bloom's taxonomy will be helpful for the planning of the course output. But my opinion, not helpful for the course output. The Bloom's taxonomy action work might be helpful for the preparation of the questioning. It is a very narrow, because of the six words, how many outcomes I could be able to get it? Okay, so that is what I am going to share with you. How to use the taxonomy for the preparation of the question bank, and why not? Okay, so that is what, why it is not applicable for the course outcomes. The next point is CO to PO or CO to PSO mapping with the justification I will be going to share with you with the probabilistic modeling game. And the next one is attainment of CO, PO, PSO. Okay? So these three are very important in the NBA process. How to? This is, all these three belong to criteria 3. Every faculty must do all these three. Every faculty. Please. Okay? So let us see now program outcomes. Already defined by NBA. But even though we need to understand, maybe tomorrow they may be going to convert into the 6 outcomes. Already for PG program, they might be converted from the 12 outcomes to the 6 outcomes. Tomorrow they may be converting into the, even for EC also, among 12, 9 or 6 or whatever the number, depending upon the committee and taking decision. But what are the key points we need to consider when we are trying to train the program outcome? The key points is one is the skill set. The second one is the knowledge and behavior. You can add one more key point that is also family. That is what next generation has to focus much on the family also. Because of nowadays you see that the families are very different at their career. You see. So you can add it in tomorrow. What is the knowledge is that PAC students know and concept they understand. Knowledge is what they understood. But how the student is able to choose the appropriate method or not for the right situation. That is what we need to incorporate in the outcome-based presentation. And skills is that skills means you know some repetition words are required for this. Skills are required, one is remembering. As per the engineering concept, but common skills are different. What are the skills you have means simply I can say I have communication skills, I have something. That is not the right answer. As an engineering student, you should answer in the proper way. That is what is the skills are nothing but remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluation, creating. These are the skills are very, very important in the process of engineering. One is remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluation, creating. These skills are very important. Okay? Skills and attitude is also very important. Attitude that dictate the goals toward which they acknowledge and skills will that personal values, principles, preferences and values. So attitude is very, very important here. Why attitude is? If I can take a decision that everyone has to accept it and follow that. Otherwise, why do they use a hierarchy in the educational system or any system? The hierarchy is not there. The problem will be always the conflicting mode. But the avoidance of the conflicting mode, the hierarchical system is there. Whether you like it or not, you obey the hierarchy. Because of everyone has their own ideas, but it is very difficult to implement all the ideas. Only one idea is possible for 100% to create. So that the hierarchical system introduced for the purpose of to avoid the conflicts only, as per my knowledge, as per my observation. Otherwise, always the we will not find the solution. We will be in the conflicting mode. So this is what you see that. So attitude is a very. The next one you see that you are aware of that course objectives, course outputs. Why? We need to understand, right? The course objectives, course outputs. You may be having some doubt, both are the same also. Then you see the statements, both the statements are same only. But what is the difference in the course objectives and course outputs? You see that? The course objectives you see that simply I have given one example. With the example I can share with you. What is the issue that students will be able to understand the concept of X and Y? Objective is nothing but what it is saying that always the teacher is asking the teacher, sorry, principal is asking the teacher what he is asking, whether you have been completed the syllabus or not, the student is able to understand or not in a lecture. These are the questions are raised by the principal. That is what you see that principal is focusing only on the delivering content or not. But you see, this is what students will be able to understand the concepts of X and Y. Objective is saying, just I am going to teach to the student. Whether the student is able to choose or not. But he understood. Students will be able to understand the concept of X and Y. But you see, course outcome is students will be able to understand the concept of X and Y in choosing, in choose suitable X and Y or X or Y for the respective domain, OBE. So what is the meaning of this? Here is the just only student is understanding X and Y. Here the student is understanding X and Y. And also he is able to choose the appropriate thing for the appropriate situation in right way. So that is the outcome. I know a number of techniques, but which is the right thing for the right situation? That is very, very important. Suppose I want to travel from here to Kukatpali, then what kind of transport mode I have to use? I have a cycle, I have a bike, I have what about car, I have a flight, I have helicopter, everything, many things. But which I have to choose with respect to the distance and also with respect to the what? Who is going to travel? Who is going to travel? Whether the person may be having more than 75 years of age, but if the person is maybe less than 25 years, his thing is I want to travel by bike because of my age is cooperative. But with respect to the data as well as the distance, you need to consider these two parameters, then only how try to choose the appropriate transport mode system only like that. So that is what the outcome. Outcome is saying simply, I am saying that repeatedly, course objectives in the government, just the techniques are the main labor and it's a better way. Having course outcomes in the government, student techniques are the main real. Sandra Mumachina, a technique, whatever, collectors to the capabilities power. Are the outcome? అది తెలిస్తేనే ఆ టెక్నిక్ యొక్క ఉపయోగం ఉంటుంది కానీ అది తెలియనప్పుడు ఎన్ని టెక్నిక్ తెలిస్తే నాకు ఏం ఉపయోగం వాట్ ఇస్ యూజ్ యు సీ ఈవెన్ యాజ్ ఎ ఇంజనీరింగ్ స్టూడెంట్ వీఆర్ డిపెండింగ్ So, but visiting of the several places in India, why should I depend on them? As a daily engineer, today what are the places you need to visit? You have a Google map machine that will make the distances and you apply the shortest route algorithm. You might be studied in civil engineering, you might be studied in engineering, EC, you might be studied in CSE. Lack of that skill is still depending on the third party. Yes, sir? Why should we depend on third party? We know how to find the shortest route. Even though we are asking to the third party, we are engaging the third party as a being educated. When we are depending on the third party, that means we are not educated, we are learned from the IT. There is a lot of difference between educated and learned. Yes, sir? So this is what concept is very, very important is to, as a being a graduate, you try to apply your method for finding something. Hello? The furnishing course files for all the subjects are posted and elaborate to handle during the course academic year. You see, suppose you are handling present one course. That course you might be handling in previous 4 years also. So that course, what are the information you need to provide to the management to see that. So, but you are aware of this, but I will tell you what is the importance of each component. Okay. So the course file contains the following information. The course file. Prerequisite required for the course. What do you mean by prerequisite? What is the importance of the prerequisite? We are neglecting, we are giving the least priority for the prerequisite. When I have visited a number of colleges, I found no one was written a prerequisite course. Without showing prerequisite course, how do I understand the present course you tell me? Without knowing the best operation, how do I apply the best operation for a big expression? So, past me. The prerequisite operation operators are very, very important. The similar way, what are the prerequisite courses that are required? Let us see here, prerequisite. Suppose I want to teach subject is what is result analysis of algorithm. For example, in computer science. Okay? For that course, what are the prerequisite courses? One is the C programming, is respected in mathematics, the third one is the data structure. So then, if the student already studied those courses, then it's easy to handle. If the students have not been studied those courses, then it's easy to manage. But I could not able to handle. You see, there is a lot of difference between the managing and the handling piece. So you can manage it, but that's not important. But you have to handle the task. This is very important. So that prerequisite courses are very, very important. So if they have not been studied the prerequisite courses, then what we need to do? We need to connect to what we extract us for the prerequisite information. Then student can concentrate on the work. Otherwise, student can get a fear. That fear can be avoidable by conducting the extra classes for the prerequisite topic. This is what my opinion is. So, play. On the duly field attendance systems with the following, you know that, press the time table, complete lesson plan, complete the entries of assignment forms, mid forms, etc. Maintain the week and drive students list with action plan for them. You see, maintain the week and drive students list. In the traditional education system, just we will focusing much on the weak students, increase the pass percentage. But now, the outcome-based education is giving the direction you need to increase both the categories, weak students as well as bright students also. So, how do you find this weak and bright list you tell? How do you identify who is the weak, who is the bright? What mechanism you need to apply for finding of the weak list and the bright list? What mechanism, what method we have to apply? You see here, I can apply, but you may be having some. What method can we apply this for finding of the weak and bright? Any one of you? But articulation of all these parameters it could be very difficult because it's a certain amount of time. We have only 4 months time. And how do we manage? Mid-mass. Okay, next, what mid-mass means present semester or previous semester or any other semester case. So now you see, there is a relation between this and this. am going to fill the relation. If so, if I am handling the design analysis of algorithm, for that course, what are the basic within courses? C programming, mathematical foundations of computer science, and the third one is the data structure. So now what I need to do? I need to collect the marks in the respective courses. Based on those marks, I have to find the need and right. I should not consider the entire semester population. The student may be very strong in the programming skills. He may be weak in other aspect. So we need to try to find the based on the certain aspect only. He may be weak in overall, but he may be strong in one aspect. How do you consider he is very strong for the lifting of the items? I may be very weak. I may be very strong for the running, but he may be very weak in the running process. For my career, different dimensions are there. So what my suggestion is, for finding out the weak and dry students is, do collect the data of the prerequisite courses. There you can find the student ability. On the basis of the prerequisite marks, then you can think how do I handle the class? Do I need to handle the class in the medium day, or maybe faster day, or maybe whatever the mechanism you can get. Without knowing the prerequisite, then how can you know whether the student is able to understand or not? Yes, sir. No. So that there is a relationship here. Yes, sir. Suppose for some of the courses, for example, first year courses. First year, mathematics, physics, maybe engineering, graphics, or something, some other courses might be there. Then how they consider? Suppose if you are taking the physics course, then you take the intermediate physics marks. And MCAT marks also is possible. On the basis of that, you can analyze the student's ability. Well, easily. So suppose professional ethics course is there. For professional course, ethics course, how do I take it? No prerequisite course. Then what I need to do? You take it as a previous semester mark overall. So that is not possible for where each subject do not have a prerequisite, then immediately you can consider the previous semester marks as the RH. That is the base or benchmark for the division into the weak and right school. Then based on this information, you need to prepare the action plan, okay? Next one is, complete the POs, PUs, PSOs, and COs. Map the COs with POs, and COs with PSOs with justification. Attainment of POs and POs, PSOs. Action plan for target missing. So what is the use of this attainment process? If the student is missing a lot, then I have to go for the action, prepare the action plan for the improvement. So this is what I will share. So maintain the following information, mid-examination question paper, answer scripts, end-examination question paper, mid-marks, and etc. Unit-wise assessment questions with numerical problems with the solution states if you need. You see here, the OBE system is always, can find whether they are really implementing the OBE system or not in this process also, assignment questions. By going through the assignments, I can easily assess and evaluate whether really you are applying or going for ultimate education. What is the, how to identify? In the assignment question, suppose there is a one question that you would define data structure. Define data structure. Is it right? Is it not correct, I think, as per the assignment process? Assignment means once you go back to the open, you open the textbook and then you will be going to write the assignment. Then how do you ask again define? Person with the numerical problem is always avoid define what is something like vector word. Memorizing questions please avoid. Remembering kind of important questions please avoid. Memorizing or remembering. You try to use as possible as applying, analyzing, creative, adapt. You focus much on the higher order skills rather than focusing on the lower order. The next one is tutorial sheets for identifying bright and weak students. You need to prepare two categories of tutorial sheets also. For a weak student, for a bright student. Why do I want to prepare? I need to encourage who is very good for the conferences, for the competitive exams, for something. Why do I need to prepare separately for the weak students? I need to get a pass percentage. I want to improve the pass percentage. For the pass percentage, it is a simple way to how to prepare. Next, prepare the timetable for NDA classes to be students only, not for the live students. the day without expecting the rest of the class work. 0 hour or maybe after the last hour. Before the commencement of the first hour or maybe after the last hour. To prepare the schedule for the remaining class. Okay, in the next hour. Prepare the gate or IELTS or paper writing or innovative projects and other competitive examination questions as a material for the right school. For high student, author and share and encourage them for attending of conferences or publishing the paper. Next, guest lectures for the for topic beyond syllabus. This lecture only is good for the right. Focus. If I focus on the weak student, first they should get a minimum mark. So, better to apply this mechanism for the right. Even when we take this lecture was in any, depending on you. And the preparation of attainment by completing the following format is that you are aware of the criteria 3. If you are aware of the criteria 3, no? Criteria 3 is a plain that we all in the outcome-based education. Okay? So, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. I will cover all these subsections. 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. So, partly, to know the criteria in all respects, you should know that in all respects. One is that every faculty or every teacher must know the course of the program, program specific of the subject you are, and what program you are teaching. Course of the course of subjects you want to discuss, what the knowledge students have gained at the end of the course. Course outcomes are indicating what the student is gaining at the end of the program. Program outcomes are what the student is gaining at the end of the program. Course is at the end of the course. Program outcomes are at the end of the program. So this is good. Write 5 or 6 COs for the subject to come. So these 6 or 5. But in the NBA SAR, before going to finalizing the number of course outcomes, please go through the manual. Go through the NBA SAR manual. In that manual, they have written very clearly around 6 outcomes. So when they have written around 6 means, please you don't apply your mechanism, either minus 1 or plus 1, but better to go for the 6 ones. Then the flexibility, but even though better to go for the 6 ones. And follow Bloom's taxonomy while preparing question papers. So for the preparation of the question paper, we have to use the Bloom's taxonomy. That is not very important is, but most of the lectures might be given using the Bloom's taxonomy preparation of the course of but not applicable for the course of the balance to why it is not applicable. Okay? Bloom's taxonomy, we have 6 levels. What are the class? 6 levels. One is remembering, means memorizing and understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, creating. I could not able to apply the, in this manner only. Sometimes some effect, or vice versa is there between apply and analyze. Yes or no? Vice versa is there. See that. Suppose if I want to decide whether you are good or he is good, first I should apply, then I have to, then again I have to compare. Then only I can decide who is good, who is not good. You see that. It's the process of vice versa my career sometimes. So remembering, please memorize. So remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating. So you see that these three, usually we used to call it by the name is the lower order systems, and these three, we used to call it by the higher order systems. In some of the articles, these 4 we used to call it the higher order systems, and these 3 as the lower order systems, which overlap. It depends on the perspective. So lower order systems, higher order systems. So now you see that what is the importance of this Bloom's taxonomy? You see what is the difference between the PG and UG syllabus? When I am asking the faculty, they used to say simply only the some units are extra. The syllabus is the same, whatever the syllabus is there in UG, the same syllabus are being available in the PG also. That is the answer I am getting several days. But that is not the right answer, please. How do you differentiate? How do you differentiate UG syllabus and PG syllabus? Are you aware of it? How do you differentiate? If you consider this Bloom taxonomy, then easy to differentiate the UG curriculum and PG curriculum. So UG curriculum much focus on the lower order skills, PG curriculum much focus focusing on the hierarchical principle. That is the basic difference between the English and the Hindi program, as per my analysis. This is the basic, they might be studying the Indian program, then they want expertise in the Indian program. So that is what you see right here. So the basic, for these three skills are very important in the Indian program. This is the, maybe if you make it as a discipline, one category, and this three are one category. For the UG students, you think you give the highest weightage for this, maybe 75% is weightage, and for this, you give 25% is weightage, and you are bringing the time. For BG students, you give the weightage for these two is 20%, and for this, for 80% is weightage. By this ratio, you can fix it as a connected as your resources availability. Resources availability is also very important when I am telling the curriculum. That's very, very important thing. Not simply to create the curriculum, you see somewhere and take it back. But if I do not have the resource, then how do I handle that permanent? That is also very important. Not to see outside university. First, you analyze to collect the brainstorming sessions at your place, whatever resources are there. You collect the resources, then you take the example of the other university. Don't go for the first itself is the example of other university. This is no one is doing. Just simply figure the curriculum. That's not the right process as per my analysis. Okay. Now you got the differentiation between the UG and PG curriculum, so that is what we need. Learning outcomes. At the end of the course, the students may have the ability to do. You see, learning outcomes. Learning outcomes can be a program outcome or program specific outcome or course outcome or any other parameter, but just simply by how much is learning outcome. You see, learning outcome must be focal in and around of these three four parameters. One is the knowledge or understanding, reason. You see, in the traditional education, in the present environment, we are focusing much only in this aspect. But remaining three, we are not covering. You see, for the remaining three, you see, we are conducting a special class for reasoning and learning. Why should we conduct a special class to study? And the question paper, if you can create in the numerical way, then it is not immediately conducting a special class for the reasoning. In the lack of the need, there are certain weaknesses that are in our question paper setting also. Due to that, we could not be able to reach the level of the market industry. So that is what you see there. So if you can set the paper with reasoning, with the numerical, then they need not go for the special training program. Yes or no? So then other one is the skill performance. How many of us thinking while teaching the course? Which is remembering, which is understanding, which is applying, which is analyzing, which is evaluation, which is creative. How many of us using those words can be teaching in the classroom? So that skill performance is very key. A skill. Skill that is what? Not only available English. Skill is really remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, creative. So that is what. And product. You see product, many of the students have been completed their degree, but they have submitted the project for the partial fulfillment of the degree. But how many are there as a product? All prototype. But industry is expecting what is expected? Products. Ready? Work. Ready? Prototype? Ready? Prototype? May not be? Work. So that is what it is. Try to focus on the product. Product is which has to be. Use it by the people, then only it is important. It's not only for the mark of the people. So we need to focus in this direction. Let us see, I will say that. Course outcomes, I have taken simple course. I think you might be very familiar. Mathematics, all of you can hear mathematics. Yes, sir. So how to take the course outcomes? You see that? The mathematics one, all different topics in there. All different topics in there. Then how to get the course out. Whether you may be happy or not, that's different. But you can change it. You have a, just only as for my analysis, as for my experience, how great the way. You can change it. You can happy in this case. So what is the algebra? Students will explore and interpret the characteristics of functions, graphs, tables, and simple algebra. Once the topic is covered, then what student is able to explore these? One is interpret the characteristics of the function, graphs, tables, and all the right tables by that topic. So this is what the course outcome, comprehensive course. You see, I am not being used even single keyword in this. group taxonomic keywords. Group taxonomic keywords are remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, creating. Any more word? But we need to write in a general way. It is a statement only. It is a statement. Yes. But it should give the meaning. But you could not be able to use all this, those words only. You can do your own way. But it should cover the whole topic. The outcome has to cover the whole topic. Which is the main topic? Algebra. You see now, by this, this is one outcome. Then how to extract any number of